Hello everybody and welcome back to yet another video. I will be explaining the grandfather paradox today. So let's get straight into it. Take this example. A crazy scientist invents a time machine which can send one back in time. He uses the time machine, goes back into the past and kills his grandfather. Why? Because he is crazy. How would this affect his life? Well, since the poor grandfather is dead, he would have no son. This means that the scientist's father wouldn't exist, meaning that the scientist himself would not too. However, if the scientist did not exist, he couldn't have created a time machine and brutally murdered his grandfather in the first place. This is the grandfather paradox. It has troubled scientists for many years, and it's a solid proof for many to believe that time travel is impossible. However, there is a solution to this paradox. Well, not just one solution, but many. The simplest and the most boring solution is that the crazy scientist would not go back in time in his own universe, but in a copy of this universe. Whatever he does there will affect the future of that universe. Hence, this universe will remain unaffected. The end result of this solution is that the scientist does not worry about dying and lives happily ever after. The end. Oh, but we don't want simple or boring solutions. We like to complicate things. Hence, another solution is also available. It is based on perpetual spiral, which is just a fancy name for time loop. Subatomic particles, many a times, do different things in parallel. This is referred to as quantum superposition. This means it's possible for time travel to create two states. The grandfather being alive and the grandfather being dead. Then the result will be two states, the scientist being alive and the scientist never being born. This can be expressed as a looping timeline of two entangled histories in parallel. The end result of the solution is as follows. The crazy scientist invents a time machine, goes back in time and kills his grandfather. So he isn't born and can't invent the time machine, meaning that his grandfather is alive. So the scientist is born, he invents the time machine, goes back in time, murders his grandfather, and the loop continues. What do you think? Is time travel actually possible? Let me know in the comments below. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. I will see you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.